Welcome back to StrategyQuant Expert Series. In this video, we will look at how to create a template from an existing profitable strategy so that you can apply the strategy logic to other markets. In this case, we will use an illustrative example of strategy we shared in 2021, almost 4 years ago, and show how to easily create such a template. So, we download the strategy and import it into StrategyQuant. First, we will show the current results of the strategy on out-of-sample data. Next, we will perform a backtest by applying the settings. Now, here the symbols just don't suit us, so we have to set the correct symbol. For this one, we will set, for example, this symbol and load the settings into the retester. We have downloaded the current data. Here we see that we have data until 7th of February 2025. If you would like to update the data to the latest version and you have the default StrategyQuant installation, simply select the symbol and click Update selected. But let's go back to the retester to show how to do the actual backtest. So let's do a current backtest and set the 1 minute precision, hit the reset dates button, and let's run it. We see that our test has already been completed, and we see that since 2021, that's when we first shared the strategy, this strategy has reached a new equity high and has earned almost $3,000 since then. Now, let's show how to load such a strategy into Algo Wizard and how to easily create a template from it. So let's head to Algo Wizard and load the strategy. Now, let's see the specific conditions. However, I will switch to full view and switch Algo Wizard to a templating mode. Please note that the template cannot be backtested in Algo Wizard due to the placeholders we place in the strategy. It can only be done in Builder. We see that the strategy uses simple conditions: when the last candle closes below the Bollinger Band for a long, and for short when it closes above it. To place appendix stop order, a moving average with a period of 30 is used here, which is calculated from the close 2 bars ago. To this value, a coefficient value is added, which is multiplied by ATR. Fixed pips are used here for the profit target and for stop loss. An analogous condition is the moving average, which is multiplied by a coefficient followed by ATR. An analog stop loss or take profit is used here. And now let's show how to create a template from such a strategy. First, we will adjust the conditions for entering the given trade, the so-called trend filter. I want periods to be generated randomly or according to the specified parameters that we use in the builder. I switch by clicking on the three dots button, then generate randomly, and here I just create the so-called placeholder. A placeholder means that a specific value is not used here, but the range that we have set in the builder is used. I will also set the deviation to default. I will leave here computed from as default from close, and I will leave shift again according to the builder settings. I click on OK and do the same with the second condition. So, set default and generate randomly here. Click on confirm. And now let's see how to set the other values. And we will proceed in the same way. I click on the given condition, but now I'm editing the exponential moving average block. So I click on generate randomly and then generate randomly again. The next step is coefficient setting. Here, I do recommend maintaining a certain range of parameters. So, if we have 2.6 here, for example, we will set the value here to 2 to 3. But to direct StrategyQuant in what it will generate, because it doesn't make sense to have a completely random number value, we can also specify the range of given parameters that should be used during the build. If you have a value of 2.6 there, for example, I recommend putting 2 to 3 there. So the range will start at 2 and 3 will be the final value, where the optimization of the given value will end. The last parameter specifies the step of the given optimization. So the value will start optimizing at 2 and then continue to 2.1, 2.2, 2.3. We determine all of this with the last step. I do not recommend giving too large a range here, but rather like specifically defining the range of the given parameter. Click on confirm, and for this value, I select random generation for the period and for the shift from which the given value is calculated. We also have the value bars valid here. We can also leave it at the default value. And I also add a trailing stop here, which we wouldn't have to. And I will just let StrategyQuant generate these values, and I'm setting these values directly in the builder. I can also specify values here, like for example with that number, but the big disadvantage is that if you generate different markets, you would have to go into the template and edit these values each time. And let's face it, this is not very practical, because then you would have to adjust it for each market separately. And it's just more practical to leave it at the default value and then define the profit target or stop loss settings directly in the builder. It is simply faster that way. So we have the adjusted value for a long entry, and now let's see how to adjust it for short entry. Here we will proceed exactly the same. So we click on MR exponential moving average, click on generate randomly again like before, and click on OK. Here we set the generate randomly value again, but we will set it to 2, 3 with a step of 0.1. Let's click on OK and move on. I will also adjust the ATR by clicking generate randomly, and the condition is adjusted. When you adjust several strategies like this, this process will become very automatic for you. So I'm going to click generate randomly for bars valid and generate randomly for profit target and stop loss as well. Also, I'm going to add a trailing stop here, and we have modified a template. Nothing is used here in the conditions, so let's go through it once again just to check it. I see that I have the placeholders set correctly. I have a condition here too, and I also have it nice for short entry. Now let's save the template. You can name it, for example, EMA template version 1 or whatever you like. And now let's go to one of the custom projects. Let's say I would like to use this template on another Forex market, like say GBP/USD. So I load this template into Builder. We have some default settings set here, and let us see how StrategyQuant will actually generate strategies based on this template. Easily click on Start. We see that StrategyQuant has generated the first initial data bank, and now we have to wait for the first strategies to drop based on the selected criteria. The generation speed, of course, depends on your computer and the selected history and data accuracy. We see that here we have the first strategy in the data bank based on the chosen logic. Let me turn it off for the moment and let's head to the source code tab. We can see that StrategyQuant found a different, or rather the optimal value for moving average. Asymmetric logic is used here. There we could, for example, set that the value should be asymmetric, but we see that the condition has just been optimized for us, and StrategyQuant found similar logic in another market, but with different parameters. We could possibly further improve this logic by, say, adding a random condition here. So right here, we would choose random condition. And if we wanted, say, the opposite condition, we would set negated condition. Here we define from which condition the inverse value should be calculated. If I were to save the template again and change the name to the same but version 2 and random condition 2, then we would load it into the builder again. So load this new version. And now the important thing. If we generate these random placeholders and condition and we want to limit, for example, the number of those conditions, here we have to specify that we want either 1-2-2 or, for example, 1-2-1 maximum number of conditions. Because if we had 3 here, up to 3 other random conditions could appear in this placeholder. Of course, I do recommend having as few conditions as possible and avoiding adding as many conditions as possible. I need to check how many conditions are generated there so that overfitting does not occur. That's not something we want. So I switch back to Builder and click Start again. We will wait for StrategyQuant to generate more strategies for us. As you can see, the whole process is simple, and even if you do not know how to code or program, you can define practically like anything with Algo Wizard. I mean, of course, it has its limits, but this is really the best tool we have at StrategyQuant because it allows us to build strategies on specifics and achieve strategies that StrategyQuant or rather the artificial intelligence would not generate and come up with. Now wait a moment and then I will review what StrategyQuant generated for us. So here we have the first strategy in the data bank and I am about to stop the build again. We see that we have added one more condition here. High or low is greater than. Again, a condition based on EMA moving average. Stop loss, take profit. Here we added a trailing stop on the short side as well. And we see that this very condition is switched as we just specified. Well, and that's it for this video. If something is not clear to you, please write to us in the comments. And also, share with us in the comments whether you also use templates or let the strategies be generated completely randomly. Thank you for your attention and see you next time.